Mr. Taz Chapunda. Mr. Taz Chapunda is the Managing Director of Malawi Agricultural and Industrial Investment Corporation and is a development economist with extensive experience across Africa, Eastern Europe, Caribbean, and Asia. He has also worked as a senior economist at the International Monetary Fund in Washington, D.C., and he has extensive experience in working with many governments. Mr. Chapunda, you are most welcome. The first question that I want you to address using the experience from your institution is this. From your experience as a public sector financial institution with private infusion, tell us briefly how the available public resources support your mandate for the agricultural sector in your country. We also know that you have managed to attract considerable amount of funding from donor agencies within a very short time. How did you do it? What are you doing differently? Since this is not the case for many development finance institutions in Africa who fail to attract donor support, given their legacy issues. Mr. Taz, over to you. Give us your beef on this.
Well, thank you very much, Thomas, SG, and good afternoon to all the listeners. And let me get straight into the question. I think there were two parts to the question. Regarding our institution, we are the Malawi Agricultural and Industrial Investment Corporation, MIC for short, which is a local DFI based in Malawi. And we are very proud to say that the government of Malawi gave us seed capital of $15 million. So that was a direct funding from the government to kickstart the institution and to get us on our way. That was really important because it set the tone and showed the commitment of the government to the Malawi Growth and Development Strategy 3, MGDS. At the heart of this strategy, of course, is we have agriculture, agribusiness, irrigation, and enabling infrastructure. So you can see in this instance that the government really put in its money to set up the organization, but also to signal its commitment to this development strategy. We were then able to engage robustly with development partners, being other regional DFIs, so another form of public support, but also bilateral donors. And I would say that we have been quite successful in a short time to get support from these other entities, as I say, regional DFIs, as well as multilateral institutions. Case in point is the World Bank. The World Bank has come forward with a further $16 million to support small and medium enterprises in Malawi, many of which are engaged in agribusiness and agriculture. And then also the UNDP. The UN has also come in to support us with grant funding. So the question, of course, is how did we do this in such a short period of time? And I would want to highlight very quickly three areas, if you'd allow me, Thomas.
Okay.
Number one, okay, I would say, is showing very clear targets in terms of specific areas of intervention, as well as the targets in those different areas. We can get into the different areas, but our sectors of focus, as we said, are around agriculture and agribusiness and small business support, but also the enabling infrastructure. But really being able to articulate very clearly specific interventions with the targets. That's number one. Number two, then, is a very high level of transparency in reporting and communicating, both with those partners, but also with the public at large. So we've been able to communicate regularly with the development partners, and we've also featured quite widely in the media, both on the television, on the radio, and indeed print media. So that level of transparency and communication, ongoing dialogue, sharing both our successes and challenges has been quite important. Last but not least has been the issue of governance. Although we have left this as the last point, it probably is the most important and most fundamental point, that as a public DFI, we have strong governance structures, including an independent board of directors, strong subcommittees, and our legal framework, our memorandum and articles of association is also a very robust document which is available to all. So with that strong governance structure and high level of transparency, we have been able to win the confidence of development partners and the public at large. Let me stop there and thank you very much for this opportunity.
Wonderful. That's great, Taz. So what I take from the end of your submission here is that when you create confidence in your institution and what you are doing, you get the necessary support you need to grow. Thank you very much.